Right, okay, so I want to create a database. So how to create a database? First of all, what is a database? Can anyone tell me what is a database?
Database is a storage one.
Collection of data and log files.
Very good, collection of data files and log files. And one more thing, one more, there are a lot of definitions are there.
It will stores the objects.
Very good, excellent.
Store the data in a table
format. Very good. These are all the definitions only. Okay, database is a collection of data files and log files. Okay, in this data files and log files, we are going to store the objects, database objects like tables, stored procedures, views, triggers, everything. Everything we are going to store. So simply, a database is a repository which we are going to where we are going to store the database objects. Okay, database objects means tables also database objects, stored procedures also database objects, views, triggers. Okay, everything are database objects only. So now I want to create a database. Okay, very simple. Okay, the GUI also very simple and command also very simple. So now let me first try as a GUI option. Okay, how to create a database? Right click on the databases, just you can see new database option. Click on this new database option, you will get a window. Okay, just simply give the database name. So of course, if you want to create a database, new database, you have to give the database name, right? So just give the database name here. So batch 33. Now I'm giving batch 33 as a database name. Okay, right. So whenever I just typed as a batch 33, the name as batch 33, you can see here logical name. Okay, just check here again. If I remove 3, 3 will be removed. If I remove 3, one more 3, 3 will be removed. Like that, it will be edited here. So what is these two? These two are files. Okay, data files and log file. This is my data file. You can see the file type is data file. And you can see the file type is log file. Okay, just expand this window. Now I'll tell you about this primary file groups. There is a different architecture actually. Okay, files cannot exist independently. Files can be created on the file groups only. So the two data files, log file, there is no file group concept for the log file. Data files will be created in the file groups only. So that's why there is a default file group in the SQL Server, that is a primary file group. You can create multiple file groups also. Okay, right. Initial size of this data file. Okay, file means every file will have a size, right? Every file is created means whether it is a 1 KB or 2 KB or 3 KB, 0 KB file will not be there. Okay, even if it is like if it is any antivirus file, then only you can find 0 KB files. Sorry, not antivirus files, virus files. If it is a virus files, then only you can find a 0 KB file. But usually, mostly there will be no 0 KB files. Okay, at least size will be there, 1 KB or 2 KB or 3 KB. So for my data file, I am going to store the objects, right? Database objects, right? So for this, the default size we can see is 2 MB. If you want, you can add the size. Okay, if you want 200 MB, you can simply click on the 2, just add 200 MB. So like that, if you want, how much size you want initially, even though if you give 2 MB also not an issue. Okay, why? Because here you can see one option called auto growth. Okay, this is my initial size of the file, of data file is 2 MB, the log file initial size is 1 MB, right? Go to this column, you can see auto growth option. Okay, this is my browse button. Click on this browse button. You can see two options. You want to enable auto growth or not? Auto growth means what? Auto growth. Automatically the file will grow. Auto growth means automatically the file will grow. Okay. So here, if my 2 MB is full, if my 2 MB is full, if I uncheck this option, and if I click OK, what is the problem now? There is no auto growth option on this data file. Means once the 2 MB is full, if you try to create any new objects, you will get error. Why? Because the file is full. I don't find any free space to create new objects. Okay, auto growth also disabled. It is not going to grow automatically. So auto growth also disabled. Okay, so that's why usually auto growth will be enabled. Why? Because even if you give very less size to the data file and log file, if you enable the auto growth, now in this case, if your 2 MB is full, okay, you can see here auto growth, there are two options. One is in percent and in megabytes. In percent, if you select, if you give 10% or 100%, 100% means what? How much MB will be added to this file now? If my 2 MB is full, how much MB will be added?
2 MB.
Two more MB will be added, right? 2 more MB will be added to my data file. So if I give 50% like that, usually you cannot give 100%. Mostly in the organization, 10% will be there, okay? Automatically, 10%, 2 MB of 10% means 0.2 MB. So the new file size will be 2 MB plus 0.2 MB, 2.2 MB, okay? Once the 2.2 MB also full, then 10% more will be added, okay? You can add in percentage or else you can add in megabytes, like you can add in 10 MB, okay? If you simply give 10 MB or 100 MB, once your 2 MB is full, 10 MB is directly going to add to this 2 MB. So the total size, the new file size will be 12 MB. If you give 100 MB, your new file size will be 102 MB. Okay. Whenever that 102 MB is completely full, like again, 100 more MB is going to be added to that particular file. So depends upon the size you gave. Okay. Usually in the organization, in percentage will be there. Okay. In percentage and 10% will be there. Sometimes they will put 20%, 30%, 50% also. Okay, right. So like that, how to, till how much size it can grow? Okay, you are giving 2 MB is completed at 10%, added 2.2 MB. So again, that 2.2 MB is also full. Again, the file is extended using auto growth option. Like that, till how much size it will grow? Do you want a limited size of the file or an unlimited size of the file? Okay, so here you can mention restricted file growth. If you select here, okay, till 1000 MB only it has to go. Okay, in that case, it will grow. 2 MB becomes to 4 MB, 4 MB, 6 MB, 8 MB, like that till 1 GB it will grow. Once you have gave 1000 MB here, till 1000 MB this file will grow. Okay, once it reaches this 1000 MB, it will not grow. You cannot create any new objects. Why? Because the 1000 MB limit is over. Okay, like if you go to this your Gmail, they will give 15 GB, right? If you go to Google Drive and all, they will give 15 GB. If you use it all your Google Drive 15 GB, either you have to purchase new storage or else you cannot use more than 15 GB. Okay, you cannot store any other things in the Google Drive also. Why? Because 15 GB is completely full. Here also same thing, restricted growth, till how much growth you want to restrict your file, 1 GB, 2 GB, 3 GB, 4 GB, like that, there is a specific growth, okay? Unrestricted growth, if you select this option, what will be your size of the file? What will be the file size? If you select unrestricted growth, what is the size of your file? Till how much size it can grow? Okay, sorry. Till how much size it can grow if you select unrestricted growth?
Till our disk drive.
Very good, very good. Okay, so in which drive you are storing your file? In which drive you are storing your file? In which drive I am storing my file now? C drive, right? Yeah. In C drive I am storing my file, right? So in C drive, how much free space is there? It will occupy all the free space. Now 12 GB free space is there, right? It will grow until 12 GB. Okay, it will grow until 12 GB, right? So if completely this C drive is completely full, then it will stop. If you extend this C drive to 100 more GB, or if you extend this C drive to 2 TB, okay, if you keep unrestricted growth, it will use all the free space if any new data is coming. if there is no new data, it will not grow, right? If the data is coming, if anyone inserting more and more records in the table, if anyone creating more and more objects, then only the file size will grow. Otherwise, if you give 2 terabytes, okay, if no one is inserting the data, if no one is creating the tables, the 2 terabytes will be like free space only. Okay, right? So till how much free space is there in the drive, till that free space, okay, it is going to grow. So there is no size restriction for the data file. If you have more space, it can grow like anything if you have more storage. But remember one thing, each and every drive in the organization, you cannot give more than 2 terabytes. The maximum capacity of a drive is 2 terabytes. Okay, you cannot go more than 2 terabytes. That means your data file size is not limited to 2 terabytes. Okay, you can add more files. Now is one data file. Okay, one data file you stored in the C drive, that 2 terabytes is completely full. Now you will create one more data file that will store in a D drive or E drive or F drive. Like that, there is no maximum capacity for the database data files. Okay, but for log file, the maximum capacity is 2 terabytes. The log file cannot grow more than 2 terabytes. Even if you have free space, the log file size is 2 terabytes. The maximum size of the log file is 2 terabytes. Up to 2 terabytes only it can grow. Okay, right? Yes, okay, fine. So this is all your auto growth option, restricted growth, unrestricted growth, everything you can see here. Okay, now simply click okay. Okay, right, by percent you can see here auto growth. If you can see none, that means what? There is no auto growth option. If you can see by 10% is unrestricted growth, means auto growth option is available. And by 10% means by every 10% it will increase. If it is completely full, 10% will be added. So the path of the data file, can I put my data file in one drive, log file in another drive, different locations?
Yes, I can
put data file. Usually in the organization we will do like that only. There is a separate drives for data file then separate drives for log file. Why? Because in the organization usually the file sizes will be 500 GB, 800 GB, sometimes 1.2 terabytes, sometimes 1.8 terabytes. Okay, in that case you cannot keep your data file and log file in the same drive. Why? Because the log is going to grow, right? So if you just keep, you can keep it, but performance wise also no issues, but you will get a space issues. You will get space issues, space alerts kind of things. Okay, that's why it is always better to keep data file is in one location, log file is in another location. Data file is in one drive, log file is in another drive. You can keep it, like how many data files are there, you can keep multiple data files in multiple drives. Okay, no issues at all. Okay, and we can create multiple log files also, not only data files. Usually you can see multiple data files will be there, only one log file will be there. People will think only data files, we can create multiple data files, but you can create multiple data files and you can create multiple log files also. Okay, right? If you want to create any file, simply click on add here, that's it, right? And file name, no need to give any file name. Automatically if I click okay, automatically the logical names can be taken as a file name. Simply batch33.mdf, batch33_log.ldf extensions will be added. File names are called physical file names. Okay, batch33.mdf, data file extension is .mdf, and the log file extension is .ldf. So like that we can identify the difference between data file and log file, right? So let me go to this second phase. Okay, option space. Here you can see collation setting. Collation setting is server default. What is your server collation setting? The same collation settings will be applied here also. If you want, you can change the database collation setting. Database collation settings you can change anytime, but server collation settings you cannot change. Okay, all right. Recovery model, we have a separate class on this. Recovery model, full recovery model, bulk logger recovery model, and simple recovery model. Okay, so we have a separate class on this recovery models. Compatibility levels. Compatibility level means what? If your server, if your database belongs to SQL Server 2005, you can see SQL Server 2005 compatibility level is 90. Okay, SQL Server 2008 compatibility level. Can anyone tell me 2008 compatibility level?
10.
Okay, SQL Server 2005.
90.
Then how come SQL Server 2008 will be 10?
Bill number.
Yeah, bill number only. Bill number there will be 10.0. Okay, so remove the dot. Okay, 100. Okay, 9.0, 10.0, 11.0 here. Beginning we have discussed. Okay, let me go to this. Right. So if you install SQL Server 2005, your build number is going to start with 9.0. What is this 90? 90 folder will be created in the C program files, Microsoft SQL Server. And in the same way, the databases that belongs to 2005 compatibility level is also 90. Very important. Okay. If you install SQL Server 2008, your build number is going to start with 10.0. And a 100 folder will be created in the C program files, Microsoft SQL Server. Yesterday we have discussed it, right? Instance binaries. A 100 folder will be created in the C program files, Microsoft SQL Server. And the compatibility level is also 100. And again, for 2008 R2, the build number is going to start with 10.50. But there is nothing like 105 like that, okay? Even for 2008 R2 also, 100 folder is going to be created in the C program files, Microsoft SQL Server, and 2008 R2 databases belongs to 100 compatibility level. Compatibility means what? Compatible means what? Say for example, we have a discussion, right? This compatibility levels and all. Okay. So if I want to give a small example for compatibility, so childhood. In the childhood days, we are going to wear some clothes. Okay, in the childhood, in the year of, like in the age of 3 years, 5 years, we are going to wear some of the clothes, very small clothes. Can we wear those small clothes now? Not possible. Why? Because our structure is different now. Our height is different. Our weight is different. Our particular like dimensions are different now. So you cannot use your childhood clothes now. In the same way, compatibility means this is belongs to 2008 R2. Okay, this particular database belongs to 2008 R2. So while installing, we have discussed about the compatibility. Okay, you cannot install lower version, very lower versions of the SQL servers into very higher versions of the Windows servers. Okay, like that, in the same way, you cannot install very higher version of the SQL server in very lower version of the Windows server. Why? Because compatibility issues will come. Okay, right. So like here, the compatibility level of 2008 R2 database is also 100, and 2012 11.0, simply remove this dot here, 110, 12.0, 120, 13.0, 130, 14.0, 140, 15.0, 150. So like that, these are the compatibility levels, as well as these are the folder names that are going to be installed or created while installing this SQL server. If you install SQL Server 2019, 150 folder will be created in your C program files, and all the databases that belongs to SQL Server 2019. Okay, all the databases compatibility levels of all the databases that belongs to 2019 is 150. Okay, clear? Any issue, any doubts in the compatibility level? So here, if you want, you can change the compatibility level. If you click here, you can go to below version, below compatibility level of the current compatibility level. Current compatibility level is 90. You can go below version, 80, 70 also you can go. So what is the use of the compatibility level of the database here? I'll tell you. If the database belongs to 90 compatibility level, if you change it to 80 compatibility level, what are the 80 means what? SQL Server 2000. Okay, so the new features of 2005 is not going to work on this database. Imagine always on. You all people know, right? Always on is a big feature in the SQL Server. Okay, very important feature in the SQL Server, right? I'll tell you. There is a separate class on the always on, right? So always on, from which version we have started? Microsoft has started this always on SQL Server 2012 onwards. It was started the always on feature. In SQL Server 2012, if I change the compatibility level from what is the compatibility level of 2012 110, if I change the compatibility level of, let me show you in my local machine. లేదు ఇచ్చి ఇచ్చి అక్కడ లేదు అక్కడ ఇక్కడ ఉంటుంది పైన ఛార్జింగ్ లో అక్కడ అక్కడ ఉంటుంది ఏదో చేయమ Okay, right. So here this is my 2012. Let me connect to this 2012 instance. Connect. Okay, so just expand this databases batch 3. Just go to any database, go to properties of this database. Here you can see the database properties, compatibility level, everything you can see. So always on is a important feature, right? So we have already discussed. Okay, go to this options page. Here you can see the compatibility level. Okay, what is the compatibility level? Even though it is in SQL Server 2012, it is showing as 90 compatibility level here. I can change it to 110 compatibility level. Okay, I cannot go more than that present version. What is the present version? SQL Server 2012. What is the 2012 compatibility level? 110. I cannot go beyond 110. I can go below 110. Okay, what are the compatibility levels below 110? 100, 90. Like that I can go, but I cannot go beyond 110. I cannot cross the current version. Okay. Right. So if any databases that belongs to 110, on those databases only I can apply always on. Okay. But if I changed my compatibility level to 110 to 90 or 100, even though the database is in the SQL Server 2012. Okay. Even though the database is in the SQL Server 2012. Okay, but my compatibility level is showing as the old compatibility level, so you cannot apply always on high availability on that particular database. That means simply the new features are not going to work on that particular database. It will still think it is in SQL Server 2000 or it is belongs to 2005. Like that only it will behave, even though the database is in 2012. If you change the compatibility level to 2008 or to 2005, it will behave like it belongs to 2005 or 2008 or 2008 or 2. Clear? Any issues, any doubts? Madhu, Ram, Srinivas?
No.
Okay, so that is the use of the compatibility level. Okay, don't forget. If you have any doubts, just let me know. Okay, right. So this is the server. Yeah. Okay, you can see here, usually no need to change the compatibility level. Compatibility level, don't change it, okay? But sometimes customer client will ask, very rare cases, very, very, very rare cases. And of course, I'll tell you where to change the compatibility level. In the migration concept, you are going to restore a old version database into higher version of the database. In that case, you have to change the compatibility level from old version to higher version. Only in that case, you are going to change the compatibility level. In remaining cases, mostly you will not change the compatibility level. Right? Clear? Right. So these are all the database options. No need to change anything. Okay, yeah. Go to, yeah, yeah.
If you have changed the compatibility level by when restoring from higher version to higher version.
Yeah, yeah, while restoring the database also will change. But not in all the cases. If you restore a lower version database into higher version SQL server, in that case we'll change the compatibility level. That is your doubt or any other thing is there?
Is there any issue if we change any compatibility?
If we change any compatibility level, is there any issue?
Yeah.
No issues, no issues. Okay. It depends how you are. Yeah.
One of my client and one project, we have done a restore activity. Unfortunately, he didn't get the result on there.
Okay.
He asked me through Skype, like, what is the issue that happened while reaching.
Okay.
My senior said, like, there is a compatibility issue, that's why restore not working.
Okay. Okay, compatibility issue, maybe he is trying to restore a higher version database into lower version. In that case, while restoring, compatibility issues will come. Okay, you cannot restore higher version into lower version. Got it? That is a different compatibility issue. Okay, different compatibility issue means you cannot restore higher version database into lower version of the SQL server. Okay, so that is also a compatibility issue. But if you restore a lower version database, imagine you restore a 2005 database into 2012. What is the compatibility level of 2005 database? 90. Okay. Even though you restore a 2005 database into 2012 server, still the database compatibility level will be 90 only. Okay. So what you have to do once the restoration has been completed, you have to change the compatibility level from 90 to 110. Right? Compatibility level, compatibility issue means there are different kinds of compatibility issues. Sometimes your application is going to connect to the database, right? Your application is going to connect to the database. In that case, application also will have some compatibility issues. Applications means some internal applications will be there. Don't think like application means only Amazon and Flipkart. These are only applications. Okay. Small, as per our requirement, I'll design a small application. Internally, I'm going to use that application. Okay. So in that case, for each and every application also, okay, that application will support only some ranges of databases that may not support a very higher version of SQL servers. In that case, if you restore the database and if you are trying to connect that application to the database, you will get compatibility issues. Clear?
Yeah.
Yeah. Why? Because the application can work only on 2005, 2012, 2008 R2 databases. But you have installed SQL Server 2016 or you have restored your database into SQL Server 2016, but your application is not compatible with the 2016 database. In that case also you will get compatibility issues. Clear? That is also a compatibility issue only. Right? Fine, right? So this is all your compatibility issues and all. Okay, right. So these are all the other database options. No need to change anything. If you go to file groups, we have a separate class on files and file groups. There I will explain about this file groups. That's it. Okay, simply click OK. Once you just click OK, automatically database will be created. Sorry, that's it. Click OK. Okay, now database is created. Batch 33 database is created. Like this, you can see. This is user database. The databases which users are going to be created are user databases. And we have two types of databases actually, system databases, where you can see in the system databases folder, master model, MSDB, TempDB, and one more system database called resource database, you cannot see in the management studio. Okay, those are all system databases, and you can see that the database which user is going to be created is called user databases, right? So I'll tell you how to create a database using a command. Okay, what is the command for that? Create, what you want to do, you want to create, right? Create, what you want to create, you want to create a database. And of course, what is the name of the database? You want to give something, some name, right? You have to give. You cannot give batch 33. Why? Because batch 33 is already existed. If you simply give batch 33, you'll get an error. Batch 33 is already existed. I'll give small change, batch 33 new. Okay, just a small change. You can give batch 33 dot, you can give batch 33 underscore one, anything, just to differentiate between the batch 33 and batch 33 underscore new. That's it. Okay. Simply, now I want to execute the query. How to execute the query? Before executing the query, you will have a parse button. This is your parse button. Okay. What is the use of this parse button? It will help you to identify whether your query is right or wrong. It will help you to identify whether your query is right or wrong. If you simply click on this parse button, it will tell you command completed successfully. That means it doesn't executed. It is saying like your command is correct. If you have any mistake, say for example here, I just removed this. Yeah, okay. Now I'm trying to parse it. It will tell you incorrect syntax. It will directly tell you incorrect syntax. It will not tell you A is missing in the database like that. You will not get that much clear errors. Okay. It will tell you incorrect syntax. Maybe here there is a mistake. Maybe here there is a mistake. Maybe here there is a mistake. It doesn't tell you where is the mistake, but it will tell you incorrect syntax near database. Okay. Like this, some kind of information it will give you. So simply add A here. Okay. Green color means that is a keyword. Okay. You can see the color is changed to green, right? Sorry, blue color. Okay, the color change it to blue, right? So blue color means that is a keyword. Okay, so this is your query. That's it. No need to give different kind times of parameters and all. Simply three words: create, what you want to create, database, what is the name of the database, database name. That's it. Just simply, once you just checked this parse button, you can execute this query by using this execute button, or else you can run Alt plus X button. You can run Alt plus X, automatically it will create. Okay, just databases. This is your refresh button. Whatever you are doing in the SQL server, you have to refresh. Okay, see here, even though I just created the database, I cannot see the new database here. But just to refresh this databases folder, you can see new database. Okay, so this is how you have to create the database. But I'll tell you one thing. Okay, let me go to this new database again. Just 1 minute, okay. Right, okay. So I'm going to give you one more database name. Okay, what I'll give, something like I'll give ROM. Okay, right. So that's it. Here also I'm simply giving ROM name, and I'm clicking automatically ROM database will be created. But here I'll show you one thing. Okay, this is a window, right? You want to create a new database, right? This is a create database window. Whatever the changes you do, you can do. You can give database name and all, everything you can change it. Okay, and you can go to option space, you can change these things also, and here also you can change these things, and you can give different locations if you want. Everything you can do. Okay, so here if you simply click script button, it will generate a script for this action. For create new database action, you want to generate a script. This is how we are going to generate the scripts. Okay, for create new database, you want to generate a script. How to generate a script? Simply give the name. and click on the script button. Once you click on this down button, this down arrow button, it will tell you to which location you want to generate a script, to the new query window or to a separate file or to the script board, like that it will tell you. Okay, so but you cannot you can select any of these things, but usually simply click on the script, automatically it will generate a script for the new query window. Means here, new query window means here. Okay, see here how much big script is there for creating a database. Okay, see here, this is all your script, this much script is there. But what I just gave these three words, create database, database name, but the actual script is this much script is there to create the database. I didn't give any of these parameters. I just give these three words, database, database name and create query. But where, even though if you give this three words, it was created to the database. What it means, who gave all these parameters? Okay, your SQL server will add all these parameters to this query. Don't think like only this query will execute at the end of the day. Okay, SQL server will add some default parameters to this query, then it will execute that query. See how many default parameters it is adding. If you want to create a database, compulsory you have to run this much script, but you cannot remember this much script, right? So that's why SQL server will give you these are all the default options. So even though if you don't give the default parameters, automatically SQL server only will add all those parameters to this script, then only it will execute, then only it will create new database. Clear? Any issue, any doubts? Ram, Madhu, Srinivas?
It will take model
properly. Yes, I'll tell you how it will create a database while discussing system databases. I'll tell you how it will take that location, how it is taking that much size. Okay, it is going to take the properties from the model database, okay? I'll tell you, we have a discussion on system databases, then I'll tell you about that one, okay? Right, clear, right? So, okay, so with that note, I'm going to close the session for today. Again, in the next weekend, okay, Sunday, we are going to meet and we are going to discuss the things, okay? If you have any doubts, just ping me, okay? Right, I'm closing the session. Thank you.
Thank you.